to create something that's genuinely new, you have to start again. And I think with great intent, you disconnect from the past.
If you never change anything, then what you can really engineer is kind of incremental. But when you're willing to change things, then you kind of open up a whole new world of design.
The new MacBook Pro is built for the very highest levels of performance. It's incredibly powerful and yet remarkably portable. It's without doubt the very best computer that we've ever built.
We focused on the features that matter most to notebook users, and we made huge leaps. For the first time, we're bringing the Retina display to the Mac. It's the highest resolution display we've ever put in a notebook. With a resolution of 2880 by 1800, this display has over 5 million pixels. That's 3 million more than an HD TV. At this resolution, on this screen size, pixels just seem to disappear. You see an extraordinary level of detail in your photos. And typography looks amazing. It's sharper than a printed page. Beyond the display, the new MacBook Pro is really a powerhouse. We knew that an all-flash architecture was a key part of driving performance. Flash delivers data up to 4 times faster and uses just 10% of the space that a traditional hard drive would use. When you combine that with the most powerful graphics chips, the latest quad-core processors, and the fastest RAM available, you end up with a machine that's incredibly responsive. Loading and working with your content is amazingly fast because we packed this machine with the latest I/O. It has 2 Thunderbolt ports, 2 USB 3 ports, and 1 HDMI port. With all of this performance, the new MacBook Pro gets up to 7 hours of battery life. And it's only 0.71 inches thin. That's 25% thinner than our previous generation MacBook Pro. And it weighs just under 4.5 pounds.
The new MacBook Pro would seem to be a complete contradiction. It's built for extreme levels of performance, but at the same time, it's remarkably portable. To create it, we rigorously question the ways in which we've designed and built our portable products in the past. One of the most significant challenges was completely changing our approach to the design of the display. By building the layers of the display into the unibody, we actually eliminated the need for a separate cover glass. And without the additional layers, without the distractions, you're just completely immersed in your content. By not purchasing standard parts, but by designing and engineering components from the ground up, we can create a product that is more elegant and that's more efficient. And there are many design innovations in the new MacBook Pro that users won't actually see, but they'll certainly experience. For example, the thermal system, which enables the machine's incredible performance, operates in a way that is nearly imperceptible to the user. Air is pulled into vents and propelled through sculpted cavities by fans with asymmetrically positioned blades. In most fans, the blades are positioned symmetrically, which creates a single identifiable frequency. We positioned ours asymmetrically to spread the sound over a variety of frequencies, which makes it seem quieter and less intrusive. Every part of the enclosure makes a contribution that directly benefits the user. The vents are also part of the structural system, creating strong beams that actually increase the rigidity of the overall product. It truly takes an obsessive approach to make a product this meticulously designed and engineered.
We've been able to optimize the software to take full advantage of the Retina display, and the results look simply amazing. Aperture on the new MacBook Pro is a total game changer for photographers. They can now zoom in and see 4 times more of their image with pixel-for-pixel accuracy, and fine-tune even the smallest details. Photographers have never been able to work on images with this level of precision. Final Cut Pro 10 takes full advantage of the system's power and capabilities. So you can now stream up to 9 camera views simultaneously, or view full 1080p video right in the project viewer and have plenty of screen space to spare. No other notebook comes close to this type of performance.
With the new MacBook Pro, we set out to design something extreme. And this led us to rethink everything about our process, everything about what's essential to a notebook. And that meant that we could design the very best computer for today and for the future. With the new MacBook Air, we wanted to design and build an incredibly mobile product, but without compromise. Everything that we've learned designing really powerful notebooks, and everything that we've learned designing really small mobile devices, culminates in the new MacBook Air.
The MacBook Air would probably not exist as it does now if it weren't for the things we've learned with iPad. We've learned how much customers care about this multi-touch user experience. We know they care about all-day battery life. It took a lot of great ideas. They informed us on where we should go with our notebooks. Sometimes when you walk away from an old technology, it can lead to a breakthrough. And that's what we've done with MacBook Air. We've designed completely around flash storage. That's allowed us to make a product that's instant on, longer battery life, silent operation, much smaller and thinner and lighter. All that happened by having the courage to say we're going to base this product around the flash technology. The key thing we've learned is touch is extremely important to how we interact with our software. If we had tried to build it into the display, we discovered that it's not in an optimal position. You don't feel comfortable holding your hand up in the air and trying to multi-touch. The best way to deliver multi-touch in the notebook is through the trackpad. So in the MacBook Air, we've built in a large glass multi-touch trackpad right below the full-size keyboard. We've done all this in an amazingly thin and light design. The 13-inch MacBook Air weighs just 2.9 pounds and measures 0.68 inches at the rear. Then it tapers to just 0.11 inches at the front. And for the first time ever, we've made an 11-inch MacBook Air. It's just as thin, but it only weighs 2.3 pounds. These are the thinnest and lightest notebooks we've ever made.
While it is really challenging designing something that's this thin and this light, it's really, really hard to design something that's also strong, robust, and this precise. Creating structure and features from a single piece of aluminium reduces multiple parts to a single one that is not only very thin, very light, but has incredible structural integrity. There is something about how truly simple the parts are, inside and out, that makes this, I think, one of the most beautiful products we've ever designed.
One of the key design decisions that we made early on with the new MacBook Air was to use flash for storage. We do flash storage differently than other computer manufacturers. Rather than package it inside a housing, we place the chips directly on the logic board so we can be much more efficient about the way we use space. This gives us a lot more room for batteries. So what you get is up to 5 hours of battery life on the 11-inch product and up to 7 hours on the 13-inch product. And you get up to 30 days of standby time. One of the things we're proud of with the new MacBook Air is it's a real MacBook in every sense of the word. It has a FaceTime camera, a dual-core processor, and fast graphics to drive ultra-high-resolution displays. And when you connect it to a 27-inch cinema display, you can power almost 4 million pixels of image. We custom-designed every part of this product, from the enclosures to the use of flash, the design of our main logic boards, the stereo speakers. Every single part is designed to fit in a certain way, in a certain place in the product, and give us a really tightly integrated kind of design.
we set a really high bar for what people should expect a Mac to be. You get incredible displays, you get fast CPUs, you get great flash storage, you get great graphic performance, all in something that's really small and light and really affordable. It starts at just $999. And that's a breakthrough to take our latest technology, this incredible quality of the aluminum, the glass, these super thin designs, all of this amazing value, and it's our most affordable Mac ever. It's really the future of the notebook.
I mean, our learning just keeps building from one project to the next, to the next. That's absolutely the case here. I mean, years and years of designing such a range of different products enables the design of the new MacBook Air.
With OS X Mountain Lion, the world's most advanced desktop operating system gets even better and makes the Mac, iPad, and iPhone work even better together. There are over 200 new features. Here are just a few of them. iCloud stores your music, photos, documents, and more, and wirelessly pushes them to all your devices. And with Mountain Lion, iCloud is built right in. Setting up a new Mac is as simple as logging in with your Apple ID. Then your personal settings and content for all of these applications are automatically set up and ready to go. And iCloud keeps everything up to date on all of your devices. Mail, contacts, calendars, reminders, and notes. And with Documents in the Cloud, when you make a change to any document on your Mac, iPad, iPhone, or iPod Touch, iCloud updates it everywhere, so you've always got the latest version wherever you are. With Mountain Lion, sharing with your friends is easier than ever. And now Facebook and Twitter are integrated right into your Mac, too. Just sign in once, and you're signed in everywhere. Then look for the Share button, found throughout the apps on your Mac. Click it, and you can easily share links, photos, videos, and documents. Or post to your favorite sites like Vimeo, Twitter, Facebook, and Flickr without even leaving the app. iMessage has been a huge hit on iPhone and iPad, and Mountain Lion brings it to the Mac with Messages. It lets you send free, unlimited messages from your Mac to anyone on an iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch, or on another Mac. You can also send and receive contacts, photos, and even HD video. With Messages, you can start a conversation on your Mac and pick it up on your iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. Notification Center makes it easy to keep up with the notifications on your iPad and iPhone. And now with Mountain Lion, the Mac gets a unified notification center too. It gives you an elegant way to keep track of the new stuff that pops up on your Mac. New emails, messages, calendar events, reminders, Twitter, system updates, and even notifications from third-party apps. New notifications appear in the same place on your desktop, then go away. If you want to see more, just click on a notification. Or swipe to the left, and the desktop slides over to reveal Notification Center. You can even update your Facebook status right from here. Safari makes browsing the web faster and smoother. It starts with a single smart search field for both web addresses and searches. Just start typing, and right away, Safari displays a top hit, search suggestions, and other matches from your browsing history. When you've got lots of tabs open and you want to flip through them, just pinch to see the new tab view, and swipe to switch between them. iCloud keeps track of them all, across all of your devices. So if you are browsing on your iPad or iPhone, you can pick up right where you left off on your Mac. Mountain Lion brings dictation to the Mac. Just put the cursor anywhere you can type, double tap the function key, and start talking.
I can't believe you guys let Tony navigate again.
Your Mac types everything you say, no special setup or training required. And since dictation actually learns your voice characteristics and accent, the more you use it, the better it gets. AirPlay Mirroring in Mountain Lion lets you wirelessly stream whatever is on your Mac to your HDTV using an Apple TV. Stream presentations, home movies, web pages, audio, and more without ever plugging in a single cable. Thanks to AirPlay Mirroring, it's never been easier to share what's on your Mac, everywhere from the conference room to the classroom to the living room. Game Center expanded the world of social gaming by connecting millions of users on iPhone, iPad, and iPod Touch. Now, Game Center is on your Mac, too, so you can play head-to-head and turn-based games between your Mac and another Mac or an iOS device. Game Center shows you the games your friends are playing and recommends new games you might like. Challenge your friends to a game or connect with Game Center members anywhere around the world. And when you finish playing, you can check out the leaderboards to see how you rank and score some bragging rights. So that's Mountain Lion, the world's most advanced desktop operating system. It makes your Mac more powerful, more fun, and it works better than ever with your iPad, iPhone, and iPod Touch.